Hi everyone, this is Louisa at the Pilates Workshop. And due to the weather forecast today that we might be expecting snow, I just thought I'd film our class for this week, just so you've got a backup if we can't get to class at all anywhere this week. And it might also be another good homework resource for you. And it's a while since I've done any videos for my YouTube channel. So if you're at home, grab a mat if you have one. If you have light hand weights, you can grab those as well, or just use a bottle of water in each hand, or maybe a tin can of the same weight for each hand. If you do have a resistance band or stretch band, you could use that. If you don't, maybe a stretchy scarf, probably not your favourite one, but a stretchy scarf would do as well, and possibly a head cushion, or just a pillow or a cushion from the sofa, or folded up towel or something like that, and then we should be ready to go. If you have a roller, grab that just to help with a little bit of standing balance. Otherwise, you could maybe use the back of a chair or edge of a table or the wall or something. So this first little section, we're going to do a little bit of standing as well as a little bit of four-point kneeling. And I'm going to do this class in little chunks so you can pick and choose what's relevant or helpful for your homework if we're snowed in later. Okay, so thank you for joining me and we'll get started. So we'll just start with standing correctly. So you all know this really well. We're just trying to make sure you can see my feet. Make sure that we're neutral and parallel. So finding your hip bones level with each other, your belly button and your pubic bone, and your hip bones facing forward, level with the middle of your knees, middle of your ankles, and the feet parallel. I always say we try not to roll in or out through the feet, so set them as best you can. If it helps, to just do a little bit of rocking through the foot, so let the toes lift and then the toes down and the heels lift. That might just help ground you a little bit. Okay. So once you've found that place, settle yourself down. Check everything's as parallel as you can. We'll just do a little bit of breathing. So it might help to bring hands around the side of your ribs. So take that wide breath in through your nose. Try and fill up the back and sides of your ribs and your lungs, and that long breath out through your mouth. So take a few of those wide breaths in, and after a few, as you exhale, just begin to connect to your center. So your tummy, your low tummy, and maybe a little bit of your pelvic floor as well. And then once you're in your zone, everything lengthened up, neck long and neutral, we're going to do our heel lift and lowers. Depending on your balance, if you have a roller or you're near the edge of a table or a chair, you might want to use the roller just lightly in front of you to help you. I'm going to move mine out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. But if you need just a little bit of support or just have that peace of mind that you've got something there to help, that might be useful to grab that now. Okay, so first off, checking we're still parallel. And as you breathe out in the centre, we'll just hover the heels up, not right up onto the toe or the ball of your foot. And then inhale, you slowly lower back down. Okay, so as you breathe out centre, hover up the heels. Inhale, keep that sense of your head lengthening up to the ceiling as you slowly press the heels down without rolling the feet in. Okay, so start with the heel lifts. And then after a few of those, when you land, we're going to add a little upright knee bend. Still keeping the hips, knees, ankles aligned and the spine stays upright. And then we lengthen back up as you inhale. So exhale, hover. Inhale, lower. Exhale, little upright knee bend. And then inhale, lengthen. I'll just show you that from the side. So as you breathe out center, little hover. Inhale, lower. Exhale, little knee bend. And inhale, lengthen. So do up to, it would be 6 to 8 repetitions of these and most of the things that we'll do during your class today. If you need to stay in parallel for any reason, please do. But if you can come into Pilates stance, that's what we'll do next. So you can, from parallel, turn out from the hips. So you're connecting your heels, your inner thighs, all the way up. So you're even just standing in this position, you'll feel your glutes and your outer thighs just a bit more engaged and alert and ready for action. Do again check the feet haven't rolled in. So we're going to same idea. We're going to heel lift first. And then we'll add on a little knee bend, a mini plie as well. So as you breathe out and centre now, try and keep that connection of the legs as you hover the heels up. And inhale, slowly lower down without collapsing through the feet. So gliding up as you exhale and inhale to lower. Stay with that if you need to. If you can add on to that little knee bend, once the feet land, make sure you're still turned out, hips, knees and feet, tiny little plie. Spine still really upright. Inhale, that sense of the inner thigh zipping up as you lengthen up tall. So you exhale, hover. Inhale, lower. Exhale, little knee bend. And inhale, lengthen. So gliding up, slowly lower. Exhale, do knee bend. And inhale, lengthen. Okay, so again, up to between 6 to 8 repetitions would be great. And then once you've done those, we're going to take a slightly wider position, so a little wider than hip width. Still turn out. Do check feet haven't rolled in, because that will affect the knees and the hips. So stacking everything up as well as you can at a slightly wider than hip width. Exactly the same idea. As you breathe out and center, we just hover the heels. Inhale, lower. So start with a little heel lifts and lowers. Use your roller or the back of the chair if you need to help with your balance. Then once you lower down, definitely check if the feet haven't rolled in and this wider little knee bend, keeping that spine upright. And inhale, lengthen. So as you exhale, center, hover. Inhale, lower. Exhale, little knee bend. And inhale, lengthen. So we'll aim to do between 6 to 8 repetitions of most things today. And this is no exception. Good. Okay, and then when you've finished off your last one, bring the legs and feet back towards your parallel position. Last week, if you're attending my classes, we did work a little bit on our standing balance. So I'm just going to review that briefly now. And we added that with our waiter's bow or hip hinge. If you need your roller or anything else, grab that now. So with the standing balance, we're going to transfer the weight onto one leg, but try not to disturb the pelvis or shorten on either side of the waist. So ground one leg without locking out that supporting knee, keep it slightly soft. So wide breath, do breathe out and send to get that sense of lengthening and lifting up. We're going to hover up one leg. Steady as you can, maybe find a spot to focus on. And then whenever you need to, lower that leg down with control. And then you can square off and try the other side. So when you're practicing this at home, maybe count, a little wobble from me there, just maybe count where you get to, maybe it's 5 counts, 10 counts, and just see if we can even that up or spend a little bit longer on your weaker side. Then we're going to add that, we come sideways on now to your waiter's bow. The waiter's bow is when we're keeping the spine neutral. As if I've got a pole behind me, the shape of my lumbar spine and my neck isn't going to change as I hip hinge forward. I'm going to keep hands on my hips, but if you want to use hands on your roller or back of your chair or table, you can do. It really helps keep the knees very slightly soft. So as you breathe out and center now, we're just going to hip hinge forward to keep that spine as neutral as you can. Okay, and then inhale, coming back up. You can keep those knees slightly soft. So as you exhale, center, just adding that hinge forward. So stay with this, with both legs and firmly on the ground if you want to. The add-on, for those of you, especially if you did attend last week, you might want to add this on, is that you'd come to your standing on one leg, just a little hover of the leg would be great. Careful not to lock out that knee, and then add your hip hinge forward, trying not to disturb that pelvis, and then gliding back up. You could do between 3 to 5 per leg. I'm just going to do a couple now to show you. Okay, so soften that knee, keep that spine neutral, and that little hip hinge forward. Good. And then we'll come up nice and tall. Shake out those legs if you want to. So your final little balance challenge for today, I'm going to use my roller to help me with this one and show you from sideways on. Hopefully you can see my feet. So we've done heel lift, lowers, knee bends with both legs. We're going to try and do it on one leg whilst balancing on the other. Okay, so this is where the roller or back of the chair might be really helpful. So if we ground one leg, hover up the other. I'm just adjusting my roller to where I feel it gives me a little bit of help. And then strong centre. Trying not to disturb that pelvis again, I'm just going to hover up that heel, slowly lower. So try the heel lift first, and then possibly you could try a mini little knee bend. Okay, a little heel lift, lower, and a really little knee bend. Okay, if I show you that from the other side, if you can still probably show you from this around, I don't know if you can see my feet very well if I have the roller in front of me. Okay, shuffling over, so hopefully I'm in view. We're transferring that weight, hovering up one leg, strong center as you come up to your little heel lift, lower, tiny knee bend. Okay, little hover, lower, this you can probably tell. This is the side I need to practice on a little bit more. Okay, we've done a nice lot of balance work there. Shake it out if you need to. We will be doing a calf stretch in a moment. It's going to do a little bit of rotation for the upper body, and you can do this in your parallel standing position, or you can come into your Pilates stance. We're going to do standing bow and arrow. So bring the arms up in front of you, soft shoulders, not up to your ears, just try to release them down, lengthen through that neck. And as you inhale, I'm going to bring one hand towards the other and draw it across the other arm. As the hand reaches your chest, exhale and then begin to rotate with the upper body. Continue to extend that arm, turn your neck and your head to look at your hand. Breath there, and then ribs bring you back and arm comes to close. And then other side. So you inhale, draw that arm across. Exhale as you rotate and then open that arm out. Breath there. And then ribs bring you back and arm comes to close. Okay, so you can stay in your parallel or Pilates stance position as you do that. If you want to add a little bit of an extra challenge, come into your Pilates stance, little knee bend. This will help keep your pelvis steady, so you've got a little less to worry about with this shifting as you go. And arms come back up again. So you inhale, draw the arm across. Exhale as you start to rotate and open out. Breath there. Ribs bring you back and arm comes to close. So you inhale, draw the arm across. Exhale as you rotate and continue to open out. Breath there and then ribs bring you back and you can stand up tall, release your arms. Shrug or circle those shoulders if you need to. We're just going to do a little bit of side reach. Again, that could be parallel, could be Pilates stance, it's up to you. I'm going to stay in Pilates stance first of all. So you inhale, glide the arm and palm up and over. Check the shoulders not right up to your ear. Arm and palm facing in and squeeze slightly in front of you. Exhale, reaching up and over. So breath into the open side without scrunching up on the other side. And as you breathe out, stacking back up and lowering the arm down. So you inhale, glide up. Exhale, reaching up and over. Breath into the open side. And stacking back up. Good. Your add-on, if you want here, is to come into your Pilates stance, little knee bend again. This will help you keep the pelvis steady and just changes the exercise a little bit. So you can inhale, glide up. Exhale, reaching up and over. Breath into there. And as you breathe out, stacking back up and lowering it down. Other side, inhale, glide up. Exhale, reaching up and over. Breath into there. And stacking back up. And then we'll come up tall, back to parallel. You need to shake out those legs at all. Please do. And then we're going to do a little bit of four-point kneeling just to get a bit of a calf stretch and to mobilise your spine a little bit more. So let me just nudge my mat over, so hopefully you'll be able to see me from here, and I'll sort of change position in a moment. So four-point kneeling, knees under hips and arms under your shoulders. Okay, so once you're in this position with your upper body, check the elbow crease hasn't spiraled forward and you're not locking out in that elbow, so keep it very slightly soft. And then I'm going to turn around to show you this exercise. I'm sorry to be rude and showing you my bottom, but I want you to just make sure we're keeping the pelvis steady for your calf stretch. Okay. So apologies for the view. I won't stay this way too long. But slide one leg away without disturbing your pelvis. Curl the toes under. And as you breathe out and center, just rock that heel back. Try not to let your bottom lift up. And hopefully you should get a calf stretch. And just rocking back to where you started. So I do that about 5 times per leg. Careful not to sink in that upper body. But once you've done your 5, sliding that leg back in with control, and you can do the other side. So squaring off the pelvis, check the elbows haven't done funny things, and then rocking back and returning. Breathing out, centering, wide across the upper back. So
up to your five and then sliding that leg back in. Okay, and then once you come back to there, I'm going to change my mat very slightly here, so hopefully you can see when I do cat in just a moment. So we'll come into your four-point kneeling. I was getting cozy with my reformer here, but hopefully you've not got too many obstacles back home. So spine really neutral, active with that upper back. Normal cat to start with you breathe out and centre, just rounding up into your cat shape. Breath there, unravel back to neutral. Either stay at that point or you can add a little extension of the upper back. Do make sure you're not just poking the chin forward, more like a little dart or diamond press back through neutral. So rounding up to your cat shape, try and soften the shoulders, curl the head in towards you, tuck that tailbone, breath there, and then unraveling back to neutral. You can do up to eight of these, just getting your upper back warmed up. If your wrists aren't comfortable in this position, you could come onto elbows, have the hands together, but the arms are still active, bottom's in the air, and your neutral spine, and you can round up in this position as well. And then once you've finished off with those, toes together, knees apart, reverse your bottom back. Okay, and just reach and release forward and take a few breaths into there. And then uncurling with control. And if you're continuing with this class and the next video, you can get yourself set up in your relaxation position, and I'll go through that with you in a moment. Thank you.